Everyone's doing it. Why shouldn't I? Rants. Specifically watch rants. I try to get worked up to this rant. I'm just too much of a calm person to get animated. But stay tuned for my rant about claims on the best watches on this episode of Adventures with Time. Making watch content for over 3 years. Over that time, with more than 130 videos, I have never made a rant video. I may have included a rantlet or two on my videos, but never a video intentionally and specifically to rant. That changes now. Best watches for, well, you name it. Best dive watch, best three watch collection, best watch for under $5,000. Best watch, period. And on and on and on. I myself have even used the best watch label in several of my videos. Guilty as charged. Let me tell you why I think it is problematic to make such assertions. Fundamentally, it comes down to the fact that there is no standardized formula for such evaluations, no metrics which have been agreed upon. It's all subjective, based on the appraiser's biases. Now, many watch enthusiasts, when comparing watches, usually in a head-to-head manner, will define several categories and then give their rating for the watches in each of those categories. The watch with the highest number of points wins. But who has agreed upon the categories? And are all categories weighted evenly? Is price more important than quality? How does one even measure quality? Even more to my point is aesthetics. This is perhaps the trait that is most influenced by one's personal opinion. Bottom line is that you cannot make a declarative statement about some watch or cohort of watches being the best, unless you follow that statement with, based on my opinion, or some other qualifying statement which explains the basis on which your evaluations are being made. That's it. Fast rant. Thanks for watching. Here are a couple of videos where I compare or rate watches. I'll see you in my next video.